You!
big move. And they didn't. They were looking at the tuna fish too, but they were taking a real long time on it, reading the ingredients on each can as if it were a book. A pretty boring book, if you ask me, but nobody has! And so, I waited a long while, and they didn't move. And I couldn't get the tuna fish cans. I thought about asking them to move, but then they seemed so, so stupid. Not to have sense that I needed to get by them, but I had this awful fear that it would do no good, no good at all to ask them, because they'd probably say something like, "We'll move, we're
time to write any more letters because I might be too busy trying to participate. So if this does end up being the last letter, I just want you to know that I was in a really, really bad place before I started high school. And you helped me with that. Even if you didn't know what I was talking about or know someone who's gone through it, it made me not feel so alone. And I know that there are people out there that say that all of these things doesn't happen. And I know that there are people out there that forget what it was like to be 16 when they turn 17. And I know that these will all be stories someday. And our pictures will become old photographs. And we'll all become somebody's mom or dad. But right now, these are not stories. This is happening. I'm here. I'm looking at her, and she's so beautiful. I can see it. This one moment when you know you're not a sad story. You're alive. And as you stand and you see the lights on the buildings and everything, it makes you wonder. And you're listening to that song on that drive with the people you love most in this world. In that moment, I swear, man, we're infinite.
What came before won't count anymore.
We can
Because a backstabbing little trash bag got exactly what was coming to her.
Chanel number two literally never had my back. Like whenever I wanted to walk across campus or walk down a long hallway, she always be like, I can't, Chanel, I have foot spurs. So instead of walking across campus in a beautiful diamond formation, we were forced to walk across campus in a triad formation like a bunch of hobos. Because Chanel number two felt like she shouldn't have to walk behind me. But you can bet, whenever I was walking down a flight of stairs, Chanel number two was right there with a helpful little nudge. Oops, sorry, Chanel. This dumb dead manatee also used her knockoff Versace and her cheap hair extensions into convincing my boo into knocking caboodles with her. So I hope you all grasp the concept that this is what happens when you knock caboodles with my boo. You end up dead, so have fun being dead, number two. You are a stupid little troll, and Home Magazine's your running for us. So if you can all join me outside for some light refreshments sponsored by SpaceBurial.today. Thank you.
Who has ever tried so hard to be significant all the time. You know, not everything in art has to be so important all the time. Not every painting has to rip your guts out and expose your soul. Not everyone wants a piece of art that actually hurts. Sometimes you just want a still life, or a landscape, or a soup can, or a comic book, which you might just learn if you ever left your hermetically sealed submarine here with all the windows closed and no natural light, because natural light just isn't good enough for you! But then, nothing is ever good enough for you. Not even the people who buy your paintings. Museums, they're nothing but mausoleums. Art galleries, oh, they're run by pimps and swindlers. And art collectors are nothing but shallow social climbers. So who is good enough to own your art? Anyone? Maybe the real question is, who's good enough to even see your art?
Thank you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. My master said, despise the Athenian maid, and hear the maiden sleeping sound on the Dankin
day round.
Pretty so, she does not lie. Near this black glove, this kill courtesy, this whore! Upon thy eye that I throw, all this power is on your throne. When thy waketh, let love forbid, sleep his seat on thy eyelid. So awake, when I am gone, for I must now to Oberon.
With a jolt from their pretend stun guns, you know, pew, 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 pew. Or a very real sucker punch, kind of like this. Either way, I just end up running away very fast. It's a different story when it comes to clowns, however. I mean, dude, it's like they carry forces of, I don't know, the dark side with them, impenetrable to any form of retaliation. For example, Papa Clown's balloon, he'll just mutilate a bigger, nastier one. Or lock him in the trunk of one of those big SUVs. He'll just multiply himself into six more clowns at the least, or spit on a clown. He'll just want to give you a big old hug. I hate clowns so much. I just become immobilized and hypnotized with fear the very second I see one in front of me. I think they should go to clown prison or something for all the very real damage they've done to the youth of this great nation we call America. I mean, they like strikes, so that's not a problem. And instead of ostrich meat, God, that stuff stinks. Sheriff Joe could just toss a balloon or some cans of silly string into the cell and then just tell them, here you go, clowns, make your own damn lunch! Woo! Get away from me, you demon bozo!
I got steamy. spend together is within my heart. And when she was sad, I was there to dry her tears. And when she was happy, so was I. When she smiled at me and held me just like she streets of town.
Were paved with stars, it was such a romantic affair.
Thank you.
My eyes or my may never take my love. And I can't even... I can't even say the word abhor. Because it abhors me to do so. And to do the act that addition might earn. Not the world's mask of vanity can make me.
We may not yet have reached our glory, but I will gladly join the fight. And when our children tell their story, they'll tell the story of tonight. They'll tell the story of tonight. Tonight.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear? Let that lonely feeling wash away. All we see is love. Maybe there's a reason. Believe you'll be okay. Cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh,
raise a glass to freedom, something they can never take away.
Tomorrow there'll be more of us telling the story of tonight.
Out of the shadows, morning is breaking. And all is new.
It's only a matter of time.
Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. Let the sun come streaming in, cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. If you only look around, you will be found.
When our children tell their story,
you will be found.
They'll tell the story of
tonight. Oh,
no matter what they tell you.